Good morning, a poem analysis by Yuvarajachugan, musical by Kamala Vijayaratna. Today we are going to look at the poem musical. Outline, general information, analysis of the poem, and point of view. General information, the poem unfolds the tragedy of war as young men march fast towards the battlefield. The speaker in the poem regrets for the condition of the soldiers as they risk their lives in the war pathetically. The writer attempts to picture an unusual image of carrying soldiers in rucks during the war scenario in Sri Lanka. The value of freedom has been emphasized in the poem as the speaker worries about the soldier's life liberating from menial joys. Smartness of the soldiers has been presented, which has been a typical characteristic for any personnel in an army. Uncertainty of life in the battlefield has been emphasized. We will start to analyze the poem line by line. The writer opens the poem with a picture of enthusiastic soldiers whom the speaker witnessed in the roads. The term green-brown helps the readers visualize the soldiers who were wearing their military uniforms. This indicates the employment of visual imagery in the poem. The dictions, singing in the first stanza and the happy in the second stanza correlate with the theme of happiness of the young men in the task assigned. At the same time, it indicates how they are fearless for the dangerous life they are heading on. The dictions drummed and beat in the second stanza indicate how they were energetic even in crucial, fearsome moments. Analysis of the poem continues. The speaker notices the boots of the soldiers, which dance according to the rhythm of the song they sing together, which distracts the attention of the people in the road. While the writer indicates these men as soldiers with the term groups of youths, the diction ruck in the third stanza, you have to change that, third stanza, shows in which the soldiers travel towards their destination. Further, the diction disclose how young men risk their precious life in wars. You have to cut the word the in the line. The diction north in the poem metaphorically indicate battlefields, the northern part of Sri Lanka, where severe armed conflicts were reported in the country. Since the soldiers are heading towards the battlefields, the writer effectively shows how these young men march towards the most dangerous shown in the country. This marching of soldiers towards the possible battlefields correlates with the alarm of the poet Alfred Lord Tennyson. Alfred Lord Tennyson in the poem, the charge of the Light Brigade emphasizes the risk awaiting for the innocent soldiers. His terms such as all in the valley of death, into the jaws of death, and into the mouth of hell symbolize how the battlefields would be for the fighting soldiers. The same message has been communicated in this poem when we look at the uneasiness and the concern of the speaker. The term long convoy indicates the number of soldiers whom the trucks carried for the battlefield. It increased the sadness to think the loss if they die in the battlefields. Though the title music suggests a pleasing experience or it awakes a joyful encounter in the reader's mind, the reality of the poem is opposite. The subject of the poem shows the worries of the speaker over the safety of these young men in the war zone. Therefore, the title has been paradoxical in the poem as it has been a contradiction of what we perceived as readers. We continue to analyze the poem. The speaker recalls an incident she encountered one day in a pet shop, which indicates the effectiveness of the flashback technique in the poem. Through this flashback, the writer pictures the reality of soldiers in their existence. Further, it indicates how they were restricted from their own freedom. The term line of caged parrots serves for the above concept in the poem. Also, it well serves to communicate the themes of liberation, freedom, and social life of the soldiers effectively. The terms such as green was fading and their days were numbered disclose the reality of the soldiers' future. We continue to analyze the poem. Through this, the writer reveals the intensity of the concept uncertainty in soldiers' lives. The diction Greenwood in the poem indicates their lovely families and the joyful societies which they miss for their role as a soldier. The diction green correlates with the pleasant memories that the writer attempts to raise in readers' minds. The term all day in the poem indicates the lifelong period of the time phase. Through this, the speaker indicates how the soldiers are affected beyond the time phase as they are separated from their loving families in their entire life. This increases our sadness, not only towards the soldiers, but also towards their families, relatives, and friends. We continue to analyze the poem. The repetition of the term frontaled to the north emphasizes the risk into which the soldiers are exposed as they are heading towards the battlefields. The willingness of the speaker for no harm has been presented through her intention of liberating the caged birds, which symbolically refers to the freedom and a normal life for the soldiers, what they missed for the country's cause. We continue to analyze the poem. Further, the repetition of the term troops of youth indicates the prime age of the men who partake in the battle. The writer shows how they go to battlefields without showing any fear for the results. Also, the writer takes a neutral role as she prays for the both parties involved in the war. Further, the speaker is helpless in the poem, though she wants to save the soldiers from sudden death in battlefields. Due to her helpless nature, she leaves these responsibilities with God and pray for a help. A blessing she pleases from the God shows her as an anti-war poetress. The poem ends, leaving worries in readers' minds, as it indicates a danger of the place where the soldiers are heading on. The saying in Tamil, the young half wants no the fear, correlates with the story narrated in the poem. Since these are playful young men, they are not seen with worries or with faces of unshed tears, as mentioned in the poem Monuments. We will look at the point of view. The poem has been written in first person point of view, where the speaker is an onlooker in the road who witnesses the convoy of army trucks. The writer reports the incidents in the road from the eyes of a passerby in the road. If the writer had selected a parent or a sibling as a speaker in the poem, the intensity of worries would have been different, as it would be another level of increased sorrow. Thank you.